I'm going to react to Lisa Stansfield, Set Your Loving Free. When I was younger, I heard, I don't know if the title has been around the world, but that song, every time I heard that song, I always took it literally. And I used to get really sad by that song, because I thought she literally had lost her child. Then I grew up and I watched the music video and I was like, why is she smiling singing this song? Why does she look like she's not depressed over having lost her child? But then it's like, oh wait, yeah, that's not what the song's really about. But still, it's kind of funny because she looks like she's having such a good time. Anyway, I'm going to listen now. Oh, I think I've heard this.
Set your love and free. My own back. Do I have to tell you?
Okay, actually, I don't think I've heard that one before. At first, I thought I may have recognized it. But I think it just, it reminds me of some other things. I realized while listening to it that slightly she reminds me of Girls Aloud, the songs where Nadine is taking lead. Just the kind of like power of her voice. And style-wise, too, some of Girls Aloud stuff was kind of like that. Like something kind of ooh. Kind of reminds me of that. I thought it was like a really nice danceable song though. Like, it's the kind of song you'd want to skate to. It seems kind of like, like she's dating somebody who's like very quiet or reserved in some way. And so she's kind of encouraging the person to not be so closed off to her and be more expressive. At least that's what I got out of it. It was good. Thank you for recommending it.